also didn't make a lot of money.
And
very charming, very cute.
But then once again you can see, I was just saying that once again the development of the movie brought the movie in an area a little bit more dramatic. You can see that in the design too. Very goofy, very cartoony, and then slowly a little bit more naturalistic. You still have some shape, still design and stylized, but it's a little bit more believable. I mean, we talked a lot of Hiccup being an adolescent, and it brought me and probably a lot of you guys around 15, 16, 17. I remember, for example, talking to my mom and saying, no, I want to do comic book, I want to do illustration. And well, it wasn't a good news. it actually went bad. and I think all that kind of traumatic moment, some people are going through adolescence in a very elegant way, let's say. It wasn't my case, and sometimes it's a little bit more complicated and difficult. We see a lot of things on TV, a lot of soaps where adolescents are really cool, they have all the gear, easy, but for a lot of young kids, actually, it's quite difficult. And I think that's this part, specifically, the writer and the director were contributing to develop. It's very important in the movie, because there is some very tense and dramatic sequences with those characters. So you can see the development. I mean, once again, it's very clear. Nico supervised it all. He did all the characters. I just put sometimes some very different step in the process for you to understand that first it took us 5 years to develop all that stuff. And it's a long process. You need a little bit of stamina to go through it. It's not like, oh, I have a vision, it's going to be like, well, it's very long. It's a little bit of a statement about, you know, all those egos that are in front of you, and that in just a huge ego. Italian ego, very old ancestry, and two French ego. But actually, all this is erased just for the sake of collaborating. Because our only purpose with all the designs, everything, is to support the story. We can do pretty drawings, we can do nice design. It doesn't matter if it doesn't support the story. So the entire aim is just this. Hiccup, once again, the first drawing of Cressida. A lot of drawing, there is a few drawing, I think it's Dan Draw, Jeffrey Bill, that's Jeffrey, I can't say his name. And once again, all the world he could be all those years, you know, to grow into an adolescent. There's some beautiful work also from Simon. Yeah.
Magico.
Okay, the dragons. So we did a bunch of drawings as well. When you start a movie on dragons, of course, there's a lot of dragons out there. Check every heavy metal piece to break up. There's a lot of fun as well, beautiful airbrush rendering on dragons. This is not what we were going for. I think we're trying to escape a little bit the lizard with wings. And we have one, which is the first one, which is the Monstrous Nightmare, which is probably our most traditional dragon. But then very quickly we are trying to go to the strange world of experimentation. And Nicolas was trying to find also a lot of different references. Like, for example, if you cross a bulldog and a dragon, well, you get a bunker. If you cross, for example, an ostrich and a dragon, you get a deadly nadir. And this one would belong maybe more to the mythological world, where you have all those weird creatures, sometimes with double heads and everything, and it became the hideous zipper bag.